Throughout the years, I've come across many influential people. Whether as a powerful teacher or an inspirational coach, I never knew just how big of an impact they would make on me until they were already gone. I've always known in the back of my mind that being literate was just part of being a positive member of society. John Scrivano, my English teacher for my senior year, sat me down last August and told me that the sky's the limit as long as I work hard. This little 5-minute pep talk may not sound like much, but it spoke volumes to me. I thought back to the beginning of my early school years, the classic kindergarten days. I replayed in my head learning how to tell time and practicing basic arithmetic. I fast-forwarded a couple years to the third grade. I remember rushing to my room after school, anxious to finish my homework and give it to my mom to check. I felt like a genius every time my mother would hand back my papers telling me how proud she was. Middle school is when I began to lose motivation to do my schoolwork, and distractions ended up getting the best of me from time to time. When high school came around, homework was seen as a hassle. Over the years, I slowly began to resent school and I never even realized it. I'd come to the conclusion that in order to be successful, things would need to change very quickly. With the help of Mr. Scrivano, I was determined to make it happen. My English teacher did not have some sort of miraculous intervention with me because I was on the verge of dropping out of high school and considering flipping burgers for the rest of my life. Mr. Scrivano just understood that I have high expectations for myself. After what could go down as one of the greatest speeches of all time, Scrivano gave me a pat on the back, told me to have a good one, and to have my homework ready to turn in the next day. As I got into my room that night, I went straight to my desk and got to work. It was like Scrivano flipped a switch and I became the 8-year-old version of myself again. I took great satisfaction in the hard work I put in over the remainder of my senior year, and who would have thought that a simple conversation with my English teacher would change my outlook I had on academics as a whole. Scrivano helped me understand that the ability to read and write applies to everyday life. Language and speaking skills are a necessity in this world that we live in, and without these assets, where would we be? He understood my train of thought, that I only wanted to learn the bare minimum so I could receive my diploma and catch the next flight to South Carolina. But his goal was to drill into my head that literacy skills are going to be of great value for the remainder of my life. For example, most people can tell you what a simile or metaphor is, but his goal was for me to effectively use these skills and apply them to my everyday speech. We all say we want to go to college and earn a degree because it is the right thing to do, but there is much more to it than following what is classified as socially accepted. Had it not been for that little conversation that day, I might not be here in Spartanburg, but instead at the local community college tightening up my GPA. Many people do not realize just how important these skills are until it is too late. John Scrivano will always be a man I look up to and consider one of the most influential individuals I've ever met.